All right, hello wine drinking people. Time for more of what I've had to drink yesterday, and our friends from Justin Vineyards were in to see us from Paso Robles. Never forget the night I spent at the Just Inn, and what an incredible place these guys created here, Justin Baldwin. And, well, he's still involved with the winery. It's been sold to the folks that own Fiji Water now, and I think they built this brand up to be, you know, multi 100,000 cases, but these guys swear the cab's just 20,000 cases. Come on, guys. It's all over the place. And a real crowd-appealing wine. There's a lot of mass appeal on all these Justin wines. The Sauvignon Blanc, Central Coast, 100% varietal. And this wine's under screw cap, which we love. Fresh melon and pink grapefruit-like citrus notes, green fig. And it has a little kind of earthy onion skin note coming on the second day. Good amount of that juicy fruit on the tongue. And a nice savory finish. Kind of a sweet, tart kind of quality you get almost from a Riesling here in this wine. At $13.50, a very good value. The Overlook Chardonnay, another winery owned by this group. Overlook from Sonoma, and this wine's a blend of Sonoma, Monterey, and Santa Barbara County fruit, and a bit of a toasted oat kind of note, rather, on the tree fruit, the apples, peaches, a hint of vanilla bean and creme flan there. A lighter style of char with a whiff of oak spice, a nice amount of juicy fruit on the tongue, a texture of skim milk, hints of that lemon zest, and lightly buttered popcorn on the finish. Very good at $21. And the Pinot Noir Overlook, a blend of San Luis Obispo, Sonoma, and Monterey County fruit. Greg Stotto is the winemaker of this brand today. And a nice amount of brown spices, dark raspberry fruit, hints of fresh earth. A nice complexity for a $20 Pinot on the nose. A good amount of that ripe black redberry fruit on the tongue, cherry and raspberry notes of brown spices, dried flowers, and a hint of fresh earth, very smooth with nice freshness at the end. A very good wine at $21. The Cabernet, this wine's aged in American oak, and you really get that sweet American oak, the dill and the cigar box spice, tobacco coming out to the red cherry and currant berry fruit. The number two cab in the U.S. under $25. Yeah. It's a bigger brand, these guys say it is. Very fruity wine on the tongue, lots of juicy redberry fruit. Smooth, silky tan, has a nice touch of toasty oak spice. Kind of has like a Snickers bar candy kind of quality to it on the second day. Pleasant, you know, nice juicy fruit, but still fresh at the end. Very good at $21. That's what we had to drink with our friends from Justin Winery. Where's the isosceles? That's what I said. They said it's coming in like a month. I'm your host, Andrew Lampasoni, signing off for the Wine Watch, saying remember, always drink the good stuff first.